How to attract wealth by using vision boards. Sometimes, life just happens. An illness strikes, financial regulations change, you get a divorce. All these and so much more will leave you cash-strapped, worried and exhausted. Maybe none of the above takes place and it could be that you just made a bad choice or two. If you're judging yourself, stop right now. Because you know who else has made bad choices? All the people who have never confessed to it. There isn't a single person among us who has never put a foot wrong financially. But instead of being cowed by their mistakes, they press on with confidence. But how do you reclaim your poise and hope after misfortune or mistakes? Everyone has their own way, but a quick and simple method is to have a vision board. A vision board is just that. A large surface upon which you cut and paste all your heart's desires. A large part of the law of attraction is visualizing your wealth mentally. Having a vision board in addition to that helps because instead of taking a deep breath, closing your eyes and dreaming of a luxury beach holiday, you can just take a quick peek at your board for reassurance. Follow these 5 steps to creating an effective vision board, or 2. 1. Make 2 vision boards. Yes, that was cheating. But here's why. Your first vision board will set the tone for the second. Your first vision board will consist of good things from your past. Get really creative with this. If you have certificates you are proud of, by all means give them a place on the board. If you have children, put their pictures on it too. It is not an easy world to raise kids in. Anyone doing it is achieving something huge. Maybe your dog fell ill and you nursed her back to being happy and healthy. Stick her photograph on the board. Look for thank you notes, letters of recommendation, successfully completed projects, cards from your kids, anything that shows that you have strength and you have gumption. Because you know you do. 2. Clear a space before you get on to making your second one. Make space for both your boards. If you work at home, you may want to put them on a wall near your desk. If you're a homemaker, stick them on cabinet doors in your kitchen. A refrigerator door may be too small. You work in an office and you hot desk? No problem. Get 2 lightweight scrapbooks and carry them around with you. Sneak a peek whenever you get the chance. 3. Collect material. This may seem like a no-brainer, but the visuals you have at hand will definitely influence what you end up putting on the board. If you only have old copies of news magazines, your vision board could end up pretty bleak. Magazines are an excellent source, so be sure to get a variety. Ask a bunch of friends what they can spare. You can even go to doctors' waiting rooms, hairdressers and nail salons to ask for any magazines they may want to get rid of. Another way to do it is, of course, Google. Search for broad categories. For instance, if you want to travel, look for luxury travel. Browse at your leisure, print and store. 4. What's your vision? This is the really exciting bit. But wait a second. Look at your first board. Look at how awesome you are. Give yourself a minute to soak it up and really feel good about yourself. Now go to board 2. What's your vision? How do you want your future to look? Use all that goodness from the first board to drive and energize the one you're doing now.
Do you always want to travel in luxury?
Find a picture of a first-class cabin on any airline. Add in rooms of hotels you'd love to stay in. Choose your landscape. Are you a beach, mountain, city, desert or forest person? You can decide, but you don't have to. Put them all on the board. If credit card debt is the foremost of your worries, make a copy of your latest credit card statement and white out the balance. Now insert $0 to make it look like you owe nothing. One final bit that should go on your board is a check. If you'd rather not use one of your own, there are countless samples online which you can easily print out. Write your name in as recipient and then fill in an amount you want. The emphasis is on what you want, because it is usually at this stage that doubt creeps in. After you've done that, fill in the date on which you expect this money. Stick the check on the board. 5. Handle with care and fun. While making the board, be sure to have fun. It should be a joyful exercise, so feel free to liven the visuals up. Use anything that gives you a warm, happy feeling: doodles, gold star stickers or quotations you love. Respect every visual that you place on the board. This is a vision of your life, a life that is just waiting for you, so handle it with care. Once your boards are completed, take a long look at them. The first one tells you just how special you are and is just extra confirmation that you deserve everything on your second board. Look at the boards as often as you can. Draw comfort and reassurance from them. It may even help to have an affirmation handy. One suggestion is, "This is my life and I welcome it." If it doesn't suit you, modify as necessary. Repeat and believe.